Hi guys, welcome all of you back to my YouTube channel. This is Virtual Tech Chat. I'm Pawan. In this tutorial, I'm going to talk about the virtual Android systems such as TWOYI and VmosPro. When it comes to 2022, there are so many virtual Android applications are released. So in this tutorial, I'm going to talk about the all of these kind of applications, and I'm going to explain the features that you can gain from using this application and the problems that you have to face when you are going to use this kind of applications on your device. So let's get started our video and see how to find the best solution for your needs according to your device requirements. So let's get started our video. Please subscribe my YouTube channel, turn on notification net and join with me. Okay friends, firstly I'm going to talk about the VmosPro application. This application is also an Android virtual system that support for you to run Android 5.1 and 7.1 systems. If you wish to use 7.1 64-bit ROM or something, you can add this kind of 64-bit or 32-bit ROM from these options. Here you can see there are many more Android virtual systems are provided by Vmos. You can install any of them, and also I'm using the modified version of this application. You can download modified version of this application also from the given link in the description of this video. Because of default version has many limitations, so I'm going to launch this 5.1 VmosPro. So you can see it's booting, and then I can launch this Android 7.1 ROM also at the same time. So here you can see our both ROMs are launching, and our both ROMs are completely launched and working properly. If I mention the requirements for you to install this application on your phone, you need to have at least 2 GB internal memory, and also you need to have at least 2 GB RAM on your phone. Otherwise, you can't be able to install this VmosPro application on your phone. So if I open this 7.1 ROM, you can see there are many applications I have already installed, and I have already installed root and explicit features to this ROM. You can see it here. And other than this, if you wish to add a root or explicit features to your newly installed ROM, you can enable root and explicit features to your ROM from these options. You can install your Google Play services and Play Store apps from enabling this tick. If you wish to change your display settings your boot animation, you can do it from here. And you can change your virtual machine information from this option. It helps you to run your games smoothly and more smartly. You can change any of your device info and other things from here. So you can see it has many more additional features. And if you have any of errors on booting your ROM, you can fix your ROM from this option. So you can see if I launched my 5.1 ROM in here, it also has many features. You can see I have running both ROMs at same time. You can refer my previous tutorial to install this both ROMs on your phone. Because of these are modified version of Vmos ROMs that has GL2 access, and you have ability to run both systems, like your original system and virtual system, at same time from enabling this option. So you can see now your ROM is running on minimized mode. You can operate your original ROM, and also you can operate in your virtual system at same time. So you can use this file transport option to transfer anything to this application. You can import your apps and all files from using this import option. or you can use your Play Store option to download application from internet. But you have to enable your data access before going to enable these options, otherwise it won't be appear on the settings. When it comes to today, they have launched a new update for Vmos Pro application that called 2.3.2 version of Vmos Pro application. You can download this application also from the given link in the description of this video. And they have launched a new ROM for this new update. You can see I have installed Android 9.0 ROM on my device from using this Vmos Pro newly installed version with 64-bit system. You can see my operating system is Android 9.0 and 64-bit. If you want to install this ROM, you need to install this newly released APK file on your device, and you need to click on this plus button to install that newly released ROM. You can download this ROM easily from the downloading menu, and you can install it on your device. Then you will be able to launch this ROM from clicking on this play icon. Now here you can see we have successfully launched newly installed Vmos Pro 9.0 64-bit ROM. You can see it has 9.0 OS. And also it's a 64-bit ROM. If I open the setting of this ROM, you can see there are new features. Other than this, their UI is also almost like Android 9.0 system, and many of features are limited, like root and exposit. I think they will add these premium features to this application also in the future. So you can follow my channel to find more updates about this Android 9.0 ROM also. With this, let's see, move on to the next part of our video. Okay friends, now I'm moving to talk about the VphoneGaga application. You can download this application also from the given link in the description of this video. This application has two variants, that called 32-bit version and 64-bit version. But most of time 64-bit version is not working properly on any Android device, because of it need many more requirements like 4GB or 6GB RAM. So you need to have that much of a stronger device to run 64-bit version of this application on your phone. Other than that, this application is mainly requiring 2GB RAM and 2GB storage to run the 32-bit version on your phone. So you can see it's very smooth application, and it has root feature, and we can install exposit into this application too. Other than this, you can open this SYS setting option to see other features that has on this application. You can change your display settings, and you can enable your Google Play Store services from here, and you can disable your root access from this option, and you can change your phone model and everything on your phone on using these options. You can change your GPU vendor from here. Then you can get a better success on playing games on your virtual system. So you can refer other settings also if you want. So if I mention the best feature of this application, it has ability to protect your games from banning. Because of this application is running under virtual disk image file, so you can get a better success rate from using this VphoneGaga application as an alternative application for Vmos Pro. So with this, I move into the next part of my video. Okay guys, now I'm going to talk about the F1VM and X8 sandbox applications. Because of these, both applications are running under same system. Only difference between these two applications is X8 sandbox application is running under Android 5.1 Lollipop system, and F1VM running under Android 7.1 system. if I mention the requirement for you to install both of these applications on your phone, you need to have at least 2GB RAM on your phone, and you need to have at least 2GB free storage as your internal storage. But both of these applications has the same Android system. If I open the setting of this F1VM application, you can see here there are many more options. F hidden and root and exposed features, picture in feature, that means this mode. And also you can change your resolution and refresh rate. And there are many more features like this. And also if I open the setting of this X8 Sandbox application, our all settings and features that we have found on F1VM application are also is included into the this X8 Sandbox application also. But only problem that we have to suffer with this X8 Sandbox application and F1VM application is the ads. Always when you are going to open applications or install applications or do something in this application, you have to watch ads. It's a very bad things on using this both X8 Sandbox and also F1VM applications. Other than that, this X8 Sandbox application and F1VM applications are running smoothly on any Android device. If you wish to install this application, you can refer the links that I added to the description of this video. Okay friends, now I'm going to talk about the TWOYI application. You can download this application from the given link in the description of this video. You need to have at least 2GB free memory to install this application on your phone. Other than that, your phone must be Android 8.1 or higher version of Android device that has 64-bit system. So you can see it has super user permissions. Otherwise, if you want to install Exposed 2, you can use Add Exposed Manager to do that. You can see you can add applications to this application from here. But only you can install 64-bit apps here, because of this application only support for you to install 64-bit apps. If you have a modified ROM for this TWOYI application, you can import that ROM from here and replace the current ROM from using this replace ROM option. But there is an additional thing that I need to tell you. Because of this application is only support to install apps, install applications but not games. Because if you going to install any game, you have to suffer from this display glitches. You can see there is a glitch. So this application is need to be updated. I think the developer will fix this problem soon. So with this, I'm moving to next part of my video. Okay guys, when it comes to here, you can see I have Android 5.1 low-end Android device that only has 1GB RAM and 8GB internal storage. You can see it here. My device Android version is 5.1, and also my RAM and internal storage is limited to 1.5GB and 4GB. So I can't use this kind of Vmos TWOYI, VmosPro or X8 Sandbox applications on my phone, because of those applications are not supported to install on this device. So how I can install Android 5.1 and Android 7.1 virtual systems on my device? If you want to install Android 5.1 virtual system with root access on your device, you can use this Vmos Lite application. You can download this Vmos Lite application also from the given link in the description of this video. So you can see I have already downloaded and installed this Vmos Lite application. When it comes to here, you can see
we are on the virtual mode, and I can enable root access for this application. And other than this, I can run this application on the PIP mode, that means this mode. So then I can operate on both systems like this. You can see I can operate in my virtual system and also my original system. When it comes to here, I can import any file to this Vmos Lite application from this import option. So now I am going to talk about Android 7.1 installation on my 5.1 device. So you can see this virtual Android application that I have already installed onto this phone has Android 7.1 system. So you can see it's Android Note, and also this application has root access also. But you can't gain exposure to this virtual Android application. Only thing you can do is you can enable or disable root access to this application. So if you want to install this application on your phone, I have already added the installation process of this application and ROM into the description of this video. Then you will be able to follow that video to install it on your phone. So with this, I am going to wind up my video. Thank you all for watching this tutorial. Please subscribe my YouTube channel, turn on notification at and join with me. I assume you all will be able to find a best and perfect virtual Android system to your phone from watching this video.